Perhaps the most awaited TV ad in the Philippines. And after the long wait, it's finally making its debut on the world stage. The man who heads the team behind the campaign is David Guerrero, Chairman and Chief Creative Officer of BBDO Guerrero Proximity Philippines, the agency made the winning pitch before Tourism Secretary Mon Jimenez, himself a former advertising executive. So tell us about the process. So of course you were very much involved in this one.
Yes, indeed. I'm really, really very involved. It was actually fun to do, and it was, you know, we came in this room every day. For about, this is why we've kind of preserved this for about 2 months, and just shared ideas. We decided to divide the agency up into like four different teams, and they sort of compete against each other.
And of course, it was top secret.
It was top secret, and we were terribly worried about the leaks, or you know, something getting out, or people talking in a bar, or, you know. But it was quite intense.
The stringent rules did not allow a briefing between the client and the agency, so they listened intently to the secretary's public statements.
We couldn't do that because, you know, he had to respect the process and not speak to anyone.
The fact is, the bad things about the Philippines are only too well known. It is the good stuff that is secret.
Yeah, we used to get the speech and read it and check, you know, try to read between the lines.
And social media was one of the key things he would...
Yes, it was. And also not to get too hung up on obstacles. You know, don't come in with, you know, our campaign idea is, you know, build a new airport or something, you know. You know, it get people over the obstacles and get people to want to come here, regardless of you know, any kind of you know, sort of teething troubles, whatever. In the end, we were able to assemble a very coherent campaign, but we had lots of different elements: TV, radio, print, social media campaign, and Facebook campaign.
When did you finally say, this is it, this is our slogan?
I think the actual line came about a week before the pit. I actually went, you know, I took all the papers, went off the beach and, you know, went diving. It came to me underwater, basically.
Really?
Yeah.
So it's your line.
I can't say it's mine, because honestly it's a product of so many people. There's 30 people that have slaved away for a long time to get to the sun. But I think it was just, I was able to get to the place, you know, that place by having absorbed all the stuff and understand all the requirements.
And being somewhere fun.
Yeah, and being somewhere fun. And actually just thinking how much more fun it is or it would be than doing the same thing in another country. You know, that was the same thing. Because actually I was on this boat surrounded by Europeans, so Germans, Swedish people, French people, you know, and I was with my son. We're not that good at diving. We've only been three or four times, so we had to get helped on with stuff. If we were in another country, we'd have been sort of just left, you know, to get on with it. But we were helped, you know, like the crew, and it was just a sense of, yeah, I'm glad we're not doing it there. It's more fun here, and it was Yeah, they'll write that down. Yeah.
So it's based on an actual experience.
Yeah, I think that's, you know, I think the best work always is. I think you do have to get as close as you can to the product.
CBDO was also behind the Wow Philippines campaign.
So I think, yeah, the Malaysia budget at the time we did Wow Philippines was something like 10 or 11 times what was being spent.
So is that not frustrating, you know, because that's a variable where you don't have any control of, and but it may reflect on your, you know, your product.
I think it's a wonderful challenge because, you know, we have the opportunity to overachieve and I think we can do this through an understanding of social media and of how people consume media these days, especially when they're planning travel. You know, I mean, most people these days, when they're planning a trip, will go online and they will ask friends, they will check recommendations. You know, there's a much more level playing field now online than there is on broadcast, you know, media. Seeing that a lot now, a lot of campaigns, even for products. You know, in fact, one can cite the example we did for Pepsi last year. So we made a film that was seen about a million times online. You know, so you can see that there is, if you make something that people find interesting or engaging, they will reward you with their attention.
How important was it to your agency to win this campaign?
So very important to me personally. Very, I mean, everyone was really, really wanted to see a good job done, and I think we wouldn't have minded somebody else winning if they had done a better job. You know, and I think actually, from some of the very generous reactions we got from our fellow competitors, they were also saying, you know, okay, we don't mind you winning because we like what you did.
You know, we take so from more than the usual.
The thread which is about exceeding expectations. I think that's what, you know, I think it's still there, but because there's still this, again, this underrated aspect, you know, that we need to correct. We need to say to people, look, you think it's this, it's actually much more. But what's, I think, more, why this is richer territory is because I think the fun, the character of fun is so Filipino, whereas the other things, you know, if just more is only part of it. It's actually it's people's desire to have fun, possibly too much fun in some. What was really, you know, so exciting, just seeing so many ideas coming back.
So you love the response.
The response was fantastic.
Even the nasty ones.
Yeah, I mean, in a way, the nasty ones spurred on more nice ones.
Much is hinged on the campaign, not just to burnish the country's image, but to increase awareness about the Philippines.
I think the Philippines is too small in the minds of people outside, you know, and I think that's the objective I think we all have, you know, that for a country of 100 billion people, it's the 12th largest population in the world.
The one of the poorest.
That our perception should be a lot greater than it. The biggest problem is not the negative perception of the country, it's just that there's zero perception of the country, and this is hard for us to imagine because it occupies so much of our brains, but actually if you go to the average guy in Germany, the average guy in England, the average guy in America, they just don't think about it, so it's just not on their radar. I think this is partly the aim of the tourism campaign, is to get ourselves into the global conversation, start having a specific point of view that people can latch onto and have something, oh yeah, that's the kind of fun place, or that's where it's more fun. That'd be our ideal point to get to.
Next, on Twitter.
So the real competition is, for all of us here, is actually outside the country. That's the real challenge, is to get recognition for the country overseas.
The BBDO office is unlike the usual. There are no doors. Corridors or offices. It's meant to be a conducive environment for creativity. The currency of any ad agency. The boss is easily accessible. His desk is just one among the many here. In the last 14 years since its formation, BBDO Guerrero has become one of the most internationally recognized creative agencies in the Asia-Pacific and the most awarded in the Philippines. It was a long road David Guerrero traversed to go back home. Right after the EDSA 1986 People Power Revolution was his first attempt, but conditions were not yet ripe for a career in advertising.
I realized it wasn't a perfect time to come looking for a job in advertising. There was still a lot of brownouts. It didn't seem that I could actually make enough money to live off it as, you know, coming in. So I had to go back and train and study, and so I got a job in London working in, you know, some of the top agencies there.
Then he moved to Hong Kong for 4 years, but always kept an eye open on opportunities in the Philippines.
My frame of mind then was to develop my skills and do the best I could. I'm not saying I had so much of a master plan that I knew when I was coming back or how I was coming back, but the opportunity came to get a job in Hong Kong, and that seemed like a step in the right direction, you know, because Hong Kong would pay well, and it would be closer to here, and it would be a kind of interesting halfway house to develop a knowledge of Asia.
His work on high-profile campaigns, including the global relaunch of Airline Cathay Pacific, where he coined the tagline, "The Heart of Asia," caught the attention of Ogilvy and Mather, which was looking for an executive creative director to be based in the Philippines.
That was it, and that was my road back. But none of that was really predictable. I couldn't have known that was going to happen, but it just... That just sort of, as a consequence of everything else I'd done, that opportunity opened up for me at that time.
In 1998, at the age of 36, a huge opportunity knocked on David's door, but it also meant taking a big risk.
BBDO, which is one of the world's leading agencies, wanted to have a presence here. They did have a previous partnership, but it was sort of unwinding, so they wanted to restart something here, and so they approached me to help set this up. And I wasn't actually that interested because it was just seemed like a lot of hard work, and going back to the beginning, we were having such a good time.
BBDO Guerrero Ortega was formed.
He joined me in deciding to take the risk to do this, and we started off from the back of his car, basically, and you know that was the original. I mean, you know, while we were waiting for everything to happen, yeah, we were invited to be the local partners, if you like, the sort of joint venture partners in this thing. So it did involve some risk on our part, so, you know, giving up our jobs and doing this, but it's also what most advertising people want to do. At some point, most people think, I want to have my own shop.
And you made waves so quickly in the local advertising industry.
And I think, you know, that part of that was because bringing in an overseas perspective on things. I mean, I'm not sure that it's all just me, but it's just you know, anyone coming in with a different perspective.
Until you became the most awarded, you are the most awarded agency in the Philippines.
Yes, at the moment, yes, we are. We never take it for granted. I mean, it's a highly competitive industry where nothing really ever stays the same.
If you could name us a few of the campaigns that you're most proud of, that you think are definitive of your work.
One of the clients, you know, we've been working with for since the agency began, and right up to now is FedEx. And we work from here to develop their regional work, and we've also done some global work for them.
I have a delivery for all Irish.
This is a campaign that's been recognized for its long-term effectiveness. Very proud of a commercial I did for Visa, you know, a few years ago with Zhang Ziyi.
This should be super. It's not
sushi! And, you know, not apart from, you know, not just because of the fact that I met her and also met Liv Tyler in a subsequent shoot, but just because it was, again, one of those campaigns that worked really well in a big way across the region. And locally, we have a lot of fun working with Pepsi.
What takes most of your time now as CEO?
Yeah, I'm very much, I'm as hands-on as I can be, and I try to, we have, you know, a whole management team that takes care of the business side of the agency, so I'm much more about focusing on the quality of the work. And the other thing is also just to create an environment for the team to have their ideas flourish, because you can't do the work yourself. But you can try to create an environment where people feel like their ideas are going to be recognized and developed and polished, you know, and I think that's what we try to do.
And it still excites you?
It's still fun, yeah, because it's still difficult. It's never easy, this job. It's one of those jobs that is, you can never think, oh, it's easy now, I've done it. Because every time you do it, you know, you're always aiming for something higher, you're always aiming for something bigger.
There's always like the number two breathing down your neck.
Sure. Rivals make you better. I think that's we believe that it'll take a community of agencies doing well to each drive each other on to be better. And we actually see that the real competition is for all of us here is actually outside the country. That's the real challenge, is to get recognition for the country overseas. That is the big overarching goal, is getting ourselves on the map.
Next on People. Why did you decide that this would be home, considering the limited time that you had spent here?
I think it was getting to understand what my father had done, and also getting the feeling that this is a place where I can make a contribution.
BDDO has reaped many international awards for its public service ads. Its campaign for Childhood Asia Philippines has raised funds to help improve the lives of street children. David Guerrero was the first ever Southeast Asian to serve as jury president for Cannes Lions, considered the Oscars of the advertising industry. His father, noted diplomat, author, and nationalist, once wrote, "There is no nationalist more fervent than the expatriate, who sees his nation with all the enchantment left by distance and absence." This may have been true for David Guerrero as well, who spent his growing up years in the UK and began his career in advertising abroad. His mother, Margaret Burke Guerrero, lives in London.
Why did you decide that this would be home, considering the limited time that you had spent here?
I think it was getting to understand what my father had done, and also getting the feeling that this is a place where I could make a contribution. I think that was the main emphasis. But yeah, I felt that was something I could do, and I'd also absorbed a sense of responsibility from my father as well. So, you know, saying that you know you owed it to the country to do something for it, and you know, and that was basically it.
David comes from a family of nationalists and intellectuals. His great-grandfather is considered the father of Philippine botany. Another ancestor was a painter, Lorenzo Guerrero, and the poet who was in the first Philippine Assembly, Fernando Maria Guerrero. His father, Leon Maria Guerrero, was the country's youngest ambassador to the court of St. James. He wrote the first Filipino, the acclaimed biography of Jose Rizal. He also wrote what is considered the best English translation of Rizal's Noli Me Tangere and El Filibusterismo. Upon his retirement, Guerrero was given the country's highest foreign service honor. From initial support for Marcos's martial law, the senior Guerrero changed his outlook.
I think my father decided to retire earlier than he would have done otherwise, and I think he decided, you know, he was extremely principled, and he thought that if he was working for the government, he was duty bound to support it. But his only option was to retire sort of on time, as opposed to try and extend his time.
If your father could see you, he'd be proud of what you're doing.
Well, it's funny. My father's birthday actually 2 days ago. And so I sort of wrote him a little letter. I didn't really sort of meaning to, but I wrote something saying, you know, that he did a huge amount very, you know, quickly, and he'd done a lot of stuff, which I haven't, you know, I wrote him, look, you know, I'm still very proud of you, and I'm going to. I've still got quite a long way to go, so you know. But I feel that we both have come at life differently, and I've obviously had a journey that's taken a different path to his. But I'm reasonably proud of what I've done, and I do want to do more. So that's, you know, it's exciting. And he set me a high benchmark.
It is the same love of country he has passed on to eldest daughter, Kimberly.
He really taught me was how to sort of be proud as a Filipino, but not be completely overbearing about it. Because obviously, being a Filipino is only one part of who you are as a person. And obviously, because of how sort of how you grow up in this country, it forms quite a big part of who you are, especially when you go to overseas. And he tells me, you know, you're a representative of your country now. The moment you leave the airport, you are a representative for, you know, all Filipinos, whether you like it or not.
In 1999, David married Angel Villanueva, whom he met professionally in Hong Kong. Both were then working for the same advertising agency, McCann Erickson. Angel from Manila and he from Hong Kong. Like David, she was raised abroad. They have a son, Leon, named after his grandfather and also after the Lion Awards held annually in Cannes. Aside from raising a family together, they share a common love.
The love for creativity, the love for excellent work that comes out of the Philippines, the love for commercials abroad that inspires us to be a little more competitive, and we're always very hopeful that, you know, the Philippines will do well globally and our work will shine outside of the country. So that's what turns us on.
Angel has since gone on her own and in the last 6 years has been publishing the Adobo magazine, which focuses on the advertising industry. She recalled the challenges they faced in their early married life, especially when David moved to another agency.
when he first came to the Philippines, it was very, very difficult for him as well, because he was deemed as this outsider, you know, winning awards and, you know, winning globally. And the local industry didn't know who he was. You know, he didn't grow up in this industry. So he himself had a difficult time. But he put his head above water. I was working at a competitive agency. We had conflicting accounts. So there was a time, because I'm loyal to my agency, being raised and grown up there, and there are brands that I really am, you know, loyal to, and he has his own brands, which are direct competitors. So we laugh because sometimes we had a refrigerator of two different brands, his and hers, and it took me some time. I mean, that was going on for about 8 years, where we were competing but living together.
With a clear understanding that I'd have nothing to do with her business and vice versa, so I think that's good for both of us.
So she can criticize your work?
Absolutely. Often does, yeah.
And how do you take that?
Well, the thing is, well, I didn't even tell her about the tourism line until, I mean, she found out about the line the same time as all the other press did. I mean, I didn't tell her anything about it. Partly because we committed not to tell anyone, but also because I just didn't want, you know, I didn't want her judgment on it before it was released. I mean, I might have changed my mind, you know. So.
Did she try and pry it out of you?
No, she knew when to stop. She just said, okay, go on. So yeah, so we know, yeah, we have a clear separation of professional and personal life.
David is now in the middle of producing an audiobook of the Noli Metangere, based on his father's translation, and intends to release it before year-end to honor his father's memory and to encourage more understanding of Rizal's work. It was by accident that David, now regarded as one of the top creative gurus in Asia, decided to make a career in advertising.
Stumbled into advertising. I think actually, ironically, by reading an ad in the paper about a school which was starting up, a postgraduate school where you could go and train and be trained by the top London advertising practitioners. And I saw that and I applied for that. And then that set me off on the way.
David is indeed his father's son, an ambassador in his own right.
In the advertising world outside, he's seen as like the ambassador for Philippine advertising. I mean, of course, there's more of us in the industry, but he sort of brought the Philippines outside, and he takes pride in that as well. He's encouraging everybody to do that. He's encouraging more people to be more global.
He may have been born in a foreign land. He may speak with a foreign accent. But David Guerrero is a Filipino first, doing the country proud in the global stage. There is confidence in the success of the Philippine tourism campaign, for it rests in the capable hands of this creative guru. I'm Cez Oreñas Rinon, and this is People on ANC. I'm not going to be able to do that.